Hello friends, welcome back, hearty welcome to you. Let us look at this interesting example related to coordinate geometry, straight lines, circumcenter. A triangle is formed by the lines x plus y equal to 0, x minus y equal to 0 and lx plus my equal to 1. A triangle is formed by the lines x plus y equal to 0, x minus y equal to 0 and lx plus my equal to 1. If l and m vary subject to the condition l square plus m square equal to 1, then the locus of its circumcenter is what? That's what we have to find out. So we have to find out the locus of circumcenter of the triangle formed by these three lines. So let's try to draw a rough diagram and see how these three lines look like. This is the rough diagram we have. We'll just have a look at and see what we have drawn. X minus y equal to 0 is this line. X plus y equal to 0 is this line. Lx plus my equal to 1. Let us say this is the line Lx plus my equal to 1. This line will intersect and x and y axis at one particular point. May not be in this particular diagram, but it will intersect. So this is the triangle we have now, OAB triangle. We have to find out the circumcenter, locus of its circumcenter. What is the approach we will follow? The first thing we know that x minus y equal to 0 and x plus y equal to 0 are perpendicular to each other, because the slope of x minus y equal to 0 is 1 and slope of x plus y equal to 0 is minus 1. You can clearly see that the angle between them is 90 degrees. That means the first observation what we have is that this triangle, whatever we are talking about, OAB triangle or AOB triangle, is a right angle triangle. We know that triangle AOB is a right angle triangle, is having perpendicular at O. So what we can say now, that we can say that it's a right angle triangle. Now what we know about right angle triangle, we know that in right angle triangle the circumcenter is the midpoint of the hypotenuse, and that means we know that circumcenter is midpoint of hypotenuse. So we know that circumcenter is midpoint of hypotenuse. That means if I am able to find out the coordinates of A and B, because we know the equations of the lines and we are able to find out the midpoint of AB, let us say the point is something like X or something, then it should be nothing but the circumcenter. Let us say if that is equal to H, K, then we can equate them. Then from that we should be able to find out the locus of circumcenter. So first approach, the first point what we are going to do now is we are going to solve these equations given and find out the coordinates of A and B. Once we get A and B, then we'll try to find out the midpoint of AB. After that, we'll equate that to the circumcenter, let us say H, K. Then we'll try to use the equation L square plus M square equal to 1, the condition given to us, so that we can get the locus of the circumcenter. First, let's find out the coordinates of A. For coordinates of A, we have two equations to solve. One is x minus y equal to 0. We have x minus y equal to 0 and Lx plus x minus y equal to 0 and Lx plus my equal to 1. X minus y equal to 0 tells me that x equal to y. Can I substitute now and say in place of yx and say Lx plus mx equal to 1? That means x equal to 1 by L plus m. This also tells me that y is also equal to 1 by l plus m. So I can go to a and I can write down 1 by l plus m, comma 1 by l plus m. That's the coordinates of a. Now similarly, let's find out coordinates of b. For that, we will take x plus y equal to 0. We also know that lx plus my equal to 1. X plus y equal to 0, x equal to minus y. That means I can write down lx minus mx equal to 1 because we know x equal to minus y. Or can I write down x equal to 1 by l minus m? That tells me that y equal to minus of 1 divided by l minus m. So that means the coordinates of b are 1 by l minus m comma minus 1 divided by l minus m. So once we got coordinates of a and b, we know that circumcenter is nothing but the midpoint of AB. So let's take a point there. Let us say this is our midpoint and we will say it is M. So what are the coordinates of M now? We'll try to find it out. We simplify and we'll write down here what are the coordinates of M. That's nothing but actually h comma k. If you take it as h comma k is also equal to whatever we are taking. So let's do that. Coordinates of M will be x coordinate of A plus B coordinate x coordinate of B. So can I say coordinates of M will be 1 by L plus M plus 1 by L minus M comma 1 by L plus M minus of 1 by L minus M. So this whole thing, add them, divide by 2, because the formula is x1 plus x2 by 2 and y1 plus y2 by 2. So the coordinates of M are, we simplify this, we get L minus M plus L plus M. That's nothing but 2L. 2L by 2 is L. So can I write them? I'll write down one more step for you. So I'll write down this is 2. I'll write down there L minus M. L minus M plus L plus M divided by L square minus M square comma again L minus M minus L minus M divided by L square minus M square divided by 2. That will be nothing but equal to M and M cancels out, L and L cancels out. I have 2L divided by 2 into L square minus M square, and also I have minus 2M divided by 2 into L square minus M square. Now 2 and 2 will cancel, so the coordinates of M are given by L by L square minus M square comma minus M divided by L square minus M square. So we got the coordinates of M. Now we know this is nothing but equal to h comma k. That's a circumcenter, because in right angle triangle the circumcenter is midpoint of the hypotenuse. Now how we have to eliminate L and M terms to get our locus in terms of h, so that we can make it as in transform them into, replace the h and k with x and y in the next step. So what we observe now is that h is equal to L by L square minus M square comma k equal to minus M divided by L square minus M square. Now we have to eliminate L and M so that we have a equation only in h and k. Now we know that L square plus M square is equal to 1. So what we will do, we will take h and k, and we also see one more thing. L minus M is like A minus B, and this is A square minus B square. So when I add them, I will cancel with the denominator. When I subtract also, it becomes L plus M. Then also I cancel with the denominator. And also we will also do H square plus K square because we have L square and M square here, which we can equate to 1. So first part, what we will do now is we will add H and K. We'll write down H plus K equal to L minus M divided by L square minus M square. That's equal to 1 by L plus M. Similarly, if I do H minus K, I will get L plus M divided by L square minus M square, which is equal to 1 by L minus M. Also, that means we know H square minus K square by multiplying above two equations. H plus K equal to 1 by L plus M and H minus K equal to 1 by L minus M. We get H square minus K square is 1 by L square minus M square. This is our equation number 1. Let's see now what happens if I do H square plus K square. If I do H square plus K square, I have to square this up. So I will have L square divided by L square divided by L square minus M square whole square plus M square divided by L square minus M square whole square, which is equal to L square plus M square divided by L square minus M square whole square. But we know L square plus M square equal to 1. So how can we write this? So we can write it as H square plus K square is equal to 1 divided by L square minus M square whole square. But we know 1 by L square minus M square is H square minus K square. So I can write down H square minus K square whole square. If you convert them into x and y, we will have x square plus y square is equal to x square minus y square whole square. This is the equation which we are interested in. Let's understand that again. We know h and k values. If we subtract them, we get 1 by l minus m. We add them, we get 1 by l plus m. So you multiply them. You get H square minus K square equal to 1 by L square minus M square. Now we want to also square H and K and add them up because we know L square plus M square is 1. So there is chance of numerator becoming 1. So we did H square plus K square. We understood that's equal to L square plus M square divided by L square minus M square whole square. But what is 1 by L square minus M square? H square minus K square. So this will become H square minus K square whole square. That means the locus is X square plus Y square is equal to X square minus Y square whole square. So that's one interesting example which I thought of sharing with you. Please do let me know your feedback. Thanks for your time and support. Bye for now.